Right there, guys. I'm Aussie Chow. I'm Coaster Chow's twin brother from Australia. And today, we're going to be hunting crocodiles. Now, I've never done a jungle adventure in months because of this city quarantine. And the rules are different in Australia. So, I've decided to go on a little hunt for a so-big crocodile. Now, I'm going to leave you in the capable hands of Coaster Chow. But I'll see you next time he reports on these so-big crocodiles moving their way to Chessington World Adventures Resort. In the meantime, I'm off to hunt crocodiles. Stay tuned for this update, and I'll see you in the next one, where I'll give you another episode of my Aussie Chow Adventures. Stay tuned. Stay safe.
So your shout-outs for this video goes to Brian Galeas, Coasters for Life, and Expedition Ed. If you want a shout-out in our next video, then make sure you comment it down below. That's it for your shout-outs today, and let's get into another Theme Park Newsroom update. Hello there guys, my name is Coaster Chow, Doncaster born, Bob built for Theme Park News, and welcome to the first of many videos coming today. We've got a lot of videos coming today. We've got a couple of things, we've got three Theme Park Newsroom updates. We've got a flaming Cedar Fair final predictions video, and then we've got the Millen Entertainment's one that I'm recording today that's being launched tomorrow. Got a couple of fact files that I'm going to record that people have suggested over the next couple of days as well. So this is going to be a busy filming schedule, and of course there's been a lot going around the theme parks. Obviously theme parks around the world are reopening still, and you know they're trying to get into the new norm and things like that. Obviously if you've watched the Coaster Force forum, if you're on there, if you watch this and you're on the forum, you'll know about Efteling, and that we could potentially be seeing like a August, September potential final result as to what's happening with this launch coaster, this next big project, and whether that's going to open and stuff like that. So, you know, hopefully around mid-August, September, between those times, we're going to get a video on that. But today, we're focusing on Chessington World of Adventures, so stay tuned later today for newsroom updates on Walby Belgium, Pleasurewood Hills, and of course the Cedar Fair final predictions video for 2021. But for today, the first video is Chessington World of Adventures. So before we get started and talk about what's been happening with the new drop ride for 2021, let me tell you how you guys can interact with the channel. If you've loved this video, make sure you hit the like button below. Make sure you also comment down below your thoughts and opinions on the video topic. And also make sure you subscribe to Coaster Chow YouTube channel for more. And click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Please share the channel with your friends, your family, and on social media. And make sure you also comment down below your video suggestions, which will be saved, your shout-outs, which will be saved for the next day's videos. And also make sure you send in your merchandise continuously on Instagram and Snapchat. The links for both are in the description down below, and I'll save your merchandise pictures with your name and location for the next merchandise showcase video. Also, make sure you get your questions in the comments down below. Use the hashtag question before or after your question, and they will be saved for our 2000 subscriber Q&A. Also, guys, make sure you reach that subscriber goal of 10,000 subs in the next 365 days and counting. If we do that, I will release Coaster Chow merchandise on a new website, as well as other projects I've got planned for the long-term future. Let's get into another thrilling video. So on the social media accounts of Chessington World of Adventures Resort, they have released this teaser picture saying, "Do not enter archaeological dig site," with loads of hieroglyphic walls, some Egyptian patterns, and also the sign is an old wooden sign nailed to the hieroglyph wall. This gives to us the feeling of an Egyptian themed attraction, and we already know as coaster fans and theme park enthusiasts what's coming to this site. For those of you who are part of the general public and have no idea what we're talking about, basically the story is Chessington World of Adventures is set to be adding, according to planning applications, a brand new drop tower ride for families in the former site of Ramesses Revenge. Now, for those of you who need a little bit of a reminder on what Ramesses Revenge at Chessington World of Adventures is, it's what's called a topspin ride. If you look on the internet for Ripsaw at Alton Towers, then you'll know exactly what kind of ride it is. But for those of you who haven't experienced Ramesses Revenge or Ripsaw, it's known as a topspin by manufacturers Huss from Germany. It was introduced to the park in 1995. It was the world's first topspin ride to feature a drown upside down element, where the riders would be squirted by water in the finale of the ride. This is located in the Forbidden Kingdom section of the park, and also next to the Ramesses Revenge attraction was the Flying Jumbos. That has been relocated to the old blue and white former carousel site, which closed when Chessington Adventure Tree, a brand new carousel ride, came into the park in 2017. Flying Jumbos was relocated to the old carousel site and was rethemed with an Elmer IP. Now, the Ramesses Revenge site is getting transformed into a crocodile-themed drop tower ride. Now, the rumoured manufacturer of this attraction is SBF Visa, known for manufacturing Poulton's Park's drop tower back in 2012 called Magma. And with so many great reviews from Magma at Poulton's Park, this will definitely be a success for Chessington World of Adventures Resort. So that, my friends, is a little bit about Ramesses Revenge, the Flying Jumbos, the whole history of the site. You can check out loads of things at the minute where you can see the latest construction and when latest construction updates comes into us in the community, and of course to the public as well. Obviously, we spoke in a previous video recently about the trademark for the name Croc Drop. I had my own thoughts on that. I thought it was a great name for a family drop tower, but if it was a thrill drop tower, then obviously, you know, it wouldn't be the best name. I think somebody said Sobek's Drop or Sobek something. I really can't remember what you said, and I can't remember your YouTube name. I'm really sorry, but you commented it down below, so I want to give a massive shout out to you for suggesting a couple of names yourself. And I really recommend you guys do that. I might do a naming contest. I might see if I can do a naming contest, see if I can come up with a better name than Croc Drop. But for a family-themed drop tower, for the market, the target market that Chessington World of Adventures are adding in, I would love the name Croc Drop for a family drop tower. I think it's a great name for a family drop tower, and I think that for the target market that's going for, I think it's a great name and a great theme as well. I think they're really going to try and incorporate the Forbidden Kingdom section. Now, one question that was put to me on social media, someone said to me, are they going to reuse any part of Ramesses Revenge, like the queue line and things like that? From what the plan suggests, we could potentially see the queue line reused, potentially. Whether that means the extension queue line, where you would go up, I think the extension queue line for Ramesses Revenge was you would go up and you'd go over this bridge bit. Can't remember if that was Ramesses Revenge's queue line or not, but I think it was. But it was like an extension of the queue line, and then you would go through and then you'd, go round and you'd go down into the main pit of the queue line in the actual pit of the ride system. As far as I know, the hot cabin, the one that operates the ride and things like that, I think that's staying. Obviously, we've seen recently the signage has been put round back, so there's potential they could refurbish those signs, or they could actually demolish those signs and bring in some new ones from scratch. So there's still a lot of questions left to answer about this development. However, I definitely think that this will be one of the standout rides for Millen Entertainment's next season. Obviously, you've got the delayed attractions from Black Mirror Labyrinth at Thorpe Park. Obviously, the World of David Williams with Gangster Granny the Ride at the Alton Towers Resort, that's been delayed as well till next year. So, you know, we are looking at a couple of delayed attractions, but in terms of new attractions from scratch, this will be the highlight attraction for Merlin next year. So, I'm very happy about this. I hope you guys are really happy as well. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this construction update here on Coast Chai YouTube channel. Please like, comment, subscribe. And for now, guys, keep on the coast life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.